Capstone House Incorporated is a local organization founded by people right here in Bay County, and we're a futuristic learning center. That is, we're a non-profit organization. We put on all kinds of programs on a variety of subjects that people seem to be interested in. We go from science to metaphysics to philosophy. We're not selling anything. We're not telling anybody what they must believe. We just like to present information for everyone's benefit, and we encourage people to come to our meetings. We have quite a few meetings every month, and we have a newsletter that comes out every month. So those are the sort of things we do. Most people have heard of Life After Life and Raymond Moody. We've gone beyond that, and we continue that. And we have a series of programs ongoing on remote viewing, which is something rather recent, and our government has funded most of that work, and I'm well aware of what's been going on for many years. And we have a Urantia study group, which is another fascinating area of study involving some channeled information. We have a paranormal or psychic group, which can include almost anything that you could imagine. And we have a space science and UFO, unidentified flying objects. And the chairman in charge of that is a retired Air Force officer involved in that study who had been involved with UFOs professionally, including myself.
Reiki is a spiritual energy that works through the practitioners and into the recipient or the client for healing purposes or just to feel good purposes. But it is a very spiritual operation. All of our energy does come from a higher being. And we're not a religious group by any means, but we are spiritual. We do transfer the electromagnetic energy of our body or spiritual body into the recipient or the client that is fortunate enough to receive our electromagnetic energies.
I'm a Reiki master here. Also teach a lot of the metaphysic programs. Teach crystals and very much involved in such. And basically, I'm a jack of all trades here. Mm-hmm. All of our programs are open to the public. They can come in and read from our library, check our library out. But to check out the books, they have to become a member of the library.
And we encourage everyone to come. We have, as we've said, many kinds of programs. And we include not only science, but philosophy and metaphysics. I'm a retired physicist. Our board members have all sorts of backgrounds, and we just encourage everyone to come and enjoy this while we're still here.
No. I'd say it was probably about my third or fourth night in the house, and I was just about to fall asleep. It was very late, and it was very dark, and I heard a distinct cough, a very deep cough at the foot of my bed, and it startled me, and it scared me, and I tried to wake Dean up, and you know, he tried to dismiss it, so there's, you know, I didn't hear anything. So, you know, I started to fall asleep again after, you know, a good bit, and in the kitchen, out of nowhere, I heard a distinct yelp. Kind of like a, it was very distinct sound. And it was very clear, very, very, very odd. A few days later, you know, we went to check our mailbox. We had just gotten the mailbox key, and we checked it, and we'd been receiving mail for two different people. And one's a male and one's a female. I do feel very tense before I go to sleep. I have night lights that I keep on, you know, around the house lit. I feel apprehensive about leaving the bed after I get in it. I don't really care too much to even leave the room. I get fearful. You know, if anything had happened, you know, and I'm sure the years that this house has existed here in Panama City, I'd like to see if anything, you know, anything strange or, you know, out of the ordinary has happened. Any type of strange incident would be that might explain this. It was very, very real. It's very scary. That's my story.
The community with our dance. We just don't want to have a segregated dance group. We really want to have a community involvement with dance. So I hope through this show you are inspired to move and inspired to move with your neighbors and your friends. And I hope that dance can create a community in your home.
And my passion, our dancing is a passion. I do it because it's fun. Anytime I come in here with these girls, I can have a bad day, and just being the energy that I get when I come in here makes me feel real good, so that's why.
Panama City is lacking a lot of arts, I feel. We don't see enough of it. When you go to New York or other places, you can go to a show and see all different styles of dance or expressions. And so that I hope that people in the community will see what we're doing and come and join us and love what we're doing, because we're trying to appeal to different cultures and bring everybody together. So I hope that you'll join us.
Living in a